Look at this side-by-side photo of these two tees. Which is better? This one is $2.50, and this one is about $3. You might not see much of a difference, so you go with the cheaper one. The problem is, when you unpack your order, you find big variances in what should be the same size tee. What should be a box of mediums has some tees that look more like smalls. So how does this happen? Achieving consistency when making tees on a massive wholesale scale is not easy. But at Bella Canvas, we've invested in technology that has allowed us to get it down to a science. We're gonna show you all of the things that go into making consistent fitting t-shirts and show you what separates us from them. But before we get into it, hit that subscribe button so you don't miss an episode of this new series. You probably assume all tees are cut the same, or even more likely, you haven't given it much thought at all. As we mentioned in our last video, there are two types of construction, side seamed and tubular. With tubular construction, there's not much cutting at all. But with side seam construction, the precision of the cutting has everything to do with the way the pieces fit together. Think like a puzzle. It also determines the consistency of garments across batches. There are two types of cutting processes you should know about: laser-guided automated cutting, which is what we do at Bella Canvas, and hand cutting, which is what all other manufacturers of side seam tees in our industry do. Let's start with what we do at Bella Canvas. This is our Los Angeles cutting floor, where we cut hundreds of millions of units a year. These cutting machines are the most high-tech in the world, and no one else in our industry has these. First, the fabric is spread by the automatic spreaders. Then, we create markers with proprietary software that allows us to fit as many puzzle pieces possible into each cut, eliminating fabric waste. Marker paper is set on top of the fabric stack, and then the fabric is compressed and vacuum sealed to make sure nothing moves even a millimeter. And finally, the laser guides this 10-inch blade across 150 layers of fabric, cutting it like butter. We also cut these tiny notches in every piece, signaling to the sewers where the pieces join together. And it's through this process we create puzzle pieces that fit together perfectly every time. Okay, so now on to the other method. This is what a hand cutter looks like. And this is what a hand cutter looks like cutting. The first problem with this method is that every operator is different. You might have someone who is left-handed and another one who's right-handed, creating inconsistencies in how the fabric is cut. Second, there's nothing to secure the stack in place. It's just a piece of paper placed on a stack of fabric. Sometimes the paper is even stuck on with some spray glue. Now imagine cutting a 10-layer cake with a big knife. There's just no way the top piece is going to be the exact same as the bottom. That's what hand cutting's like. This is why the highest tolerance, meaning the degree of variance you can expect from garment to garment, for the hand cutters is 1/4 inch, while ours is 1/64 inch. This might not seem like a big deal, but it's these little variances that create imperfect puzzle pieces that don't quite fit together as well. And this is why you're likely to find noticeable fit differences across the exact same size and style of a garment with other brands. So why doesn't everyone use automated cutters? Because they're freaking expensive, and labor is cheap when you cut your garments in Central America, which is the way most manufacturers keep their costs down. It's a short-sighted plan that makes the assumption that you, the consumer, won't notice a less than perfect shirt construction. At Bella Canvas, our efficiencies lie in technology, not in cheap labor. By investing in top-of-the-line tech, we're able to make better quality goods and keep all of our cutting right here in Los Angeles. We are all about transparency and want to show you how we make tees from start to finish so you can see what separates us from them. Next week, we're gonna break down the different types of cotton. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss an episode.